Hello, this is Kevin from Electron Fuel Systems, and I'm going to explain to you how to do the basic setup on electron carburetors. We'll first start out here. We'll explain a little bit about how the electron works. There's no jets at all, and it uses a single metering device, which is a metering rod, and it's precisionly ground from idle all the way to the top end. When we grind them here at Electron, we use a very precise method. It's called a comparator, and it probes each spot in the metering rod at tenths of a thousandth of an inch. And we can actually program it in. Nowadays, the old days, Electron, they would simply tune it to plug readings and things like that and then grind it to different spots. Now we can actually take a dyno, put a bike on a dyno, get the readings from an O2 sensor, and then plug those in on a laptop to the CNC grinder and convert it into fuel ratios. And actually, like almost like fuel injection, we're programming it. We can add less fuel to different spots. So when you receive your carburetors from Electron Fuel Systems, they're already pre-dynoed and they're ready and set. But if you're starting off and you don't have that luxury, and you're starting off with new metering rods, or you're just rebuilding your carburetors, and you don't have a starting point, we make a thing called a fuel ratio tool. And the fuel ratio tool helps you determine where to start this at idle. Always remember that when you are adjusting the metering rod, it's always only for idle. The metering rod itself, when you adjust it, when you move it in, you're reaching it up. When you move it out, you're leaning it out. Out lengthens the rod, in shortens the rod. Now when you adjust the rod, let's say you want to richen it up one full turn. When you did that, you radically change the low end. Normally we go quarter turns at a time. A full turn is quite a bit. That'd be very odd to do. When I did that full turn adjustment, I radically changed the fuel ratio at idle. But on top end, I didn't change it at all. And what happens is the meter rod, the way it's ground, it gets very aggressive at idle and not aggressive at all at top end. So as you screw this rod in or out, out to lean it out, you're radically moving the taper on the low end. But on the top end, it's zero. The reason for this is when the rod is ground, it goes to the tenths of the thousandths on the bottom end. And in the top end, it varies almost none at all. So if I was actually to measure this metering rod with this tool at this one point, and I move it, ratchet it up, it moves it a couple thousandths of an inch. On the top end, it moves a tenths of a thousandth of an inch. It doesn't change. And that's why I always tell people, you always adjust the metering rod so it idles and responds well, never for the top end. The metering rod is adjusted just for low speeds and idle only. So let's say we got our metering rod and they're brand new. What we used to do in the old school was take a pair of vinyl calipers, start them up here, and we measure the length of the metering rod. Then we get a number, and we record that number. Then we get another one, and we do all four cylinders, if you're dealing with four cylinder, and set them that way. Well, that was okay back then, but we didn't have the other tools available. This metering rod, this taper is always exactly the same for each metering rod. But the relationship to the taper and the tip can vary. This tip, it's hard to see on the video, but the very end of the tip is tapered and then it's just deburred and cut off. Well, that tip can vary up to probably 20 thousandths of an inch sometimes. So, if we're measuring the tip, that point to that point, it's only a very, very generic setting and not the way I would recommend doing it anymore. You'd struggle. So to help people out, I invented the fuel meter here. This air fuel tool is used, and what it does is it simulates. We know where idle is on the electron. There's a slide, there's a cutaway, and we know right where it should be. This fuel ratio tool actually comes down and probes the metering rod right at idle. We know exactly where it sits in the carburetor, so we can know, put it precisely right on where we want it to be. So what we do is we lift this up so we're not dragging across the pen and wearing the pen out. Lift it up, install the metering rod, just like you would in a carburetor. Now it's in the carburetor, it thinks it's in a carburetor. You let the probe down and it probes it. Now with the fuel ratio tool, what you're trying to achieve is zero. Anything on the left side of zero indicates the bike rich. Anything on the right side of zero indicates the bike's lean. So as I look right now, I'm past zero, so I know it's rich. Now, what you should do is you should rock it when you get to be, you want to make a real precise adjustment. You rock the rod back and forth, and what you're doing, you're trying to find the lowest spot of the rod, and you can see it rocks one way, and then it rocks the other way. That's the hardest part to actually explain on the phone. What I'm doing is, I'll put this on here to exaggerate, I'm just turning this rod back and forth like that. I'm rocking it back and forth, back and forth. And when I do that, I'm watching my gauge. It goes back, it swings to the left, and goes back to the right. And I try to explain on the phone is, when you go to the left, and then it goes back to the right. When it's at the left, it's at the lowest part of the metering rod. Rocking it left, goes back. So we know that right now this is too rich. So to fix that, I have to lean the bike out. If I put this in the bike, it would run way rich. So I take the tool here, and I know it's rich, so I have to lean the rod out. So I'm going to unscrew the rod. I'm going to go one full turn. I know, because I've done this a bunch of times, I think I'm way off, so I'm going to go two full turns. That's a radical adjustment, but I think we're going to get close with that. Put it down, put it back in the tool, lift it up so you're not dragging across the metering rod. Put it back down in, and then rock it back and forth and see where you're at. I just about nailed it perfect. Looks like I'm off maybe a quarter turn. See, I'm just a little bit right to zero. I mean, it's still lean. So I'm going to richen it up now, one quarter of a turn, because I went a little bit too much. One quarter of a turn, small adjustment. Put the tool down, push in, let it snap down in the groove there. So the meter rod's facing towards the engine. Lift up, put it back in the tool, check our settings again, and it's perfect on zero. Now if I take this out and put it in a bike, it'll run perfect. It'll start up, idle perfect. Usually what you'll do is you'll do a quarter turn adjustments, and to be sure that everybody understands that, you take the meter rod, I'm going to do one quarter turn rich, one quarter of a turn. Now the rod is facing in the wrong direction, so now there's a spring, you can feel a spring. Push that spring in, collapse it, spin the rod back, let it drop down in the little notch, and you did your adjustment. I can verify that with a pair of calipers. So I know, and I suggest people doing this all the time so they know they actually did the adjustment. If you're not really new, you're new with it, zero your calipers. It's on zero. Now I know if I'm going to do my adjustment, turn it, put it back. Before I put it in the gauge, you can check and make sure you did your adjustment. It moved the thousandths and a half. That's what usually moves in a quarter turn. If it doesn't, then you know you didn't do your adjustment. And that's basically how you do the basic setup with a fuel ratio tool. We're going to move on and we're going to show you actually how to run them on a four-cylinder bike now. We're going to do it on a one-cylinder, but we figure we'll challenge a four-cylinder, give you a big challenge. So we're going to go to the dyno room and do the four-cylinder one.